Hey everybody, it's old Pappy back with another one. Thanks for tuning in. Today we finally get to find out what all this Pendragon mystery has all been about. That's been all over the web pages on Pixonic's Facebook page and on its official page. But first of all, you're probably thinking, what in the world? What am I watching here? What is this film? What's this movie? What's this footage from? Well, it's actually footage from Monty Python and the Holy Grail. And what you saw there was King Arthur and the boys walking through the forest, and suddenly he runs across this deadly, dangerous, giant knight, the Knights of Nee. And I gotta laugh because that's what came to mind when I found out what the Pendragon actually is. It is a giant robot, a giant knight from the Knights of Camelot set, named after King Arthur, of course, from the Arthurian legends. And it reminds me of the Knights of Nee. What can I say? It's bigger than your normal robot. It's almost two-thirds larger. It's more powerful. And it could be a game changer, because this is going to be something that every single one of you will be able to have in your hangar. It's true. Pixonic revealed today that everyone will be getting a extra slot in their hangar. So instead of just five robots, you'll be able to have six, but the sixth slot is reserved for what's called a Titan. And this Arthur is the first of three Titans that are going to be introduced to the game. Now, the idea is everybody gets one, and you only get to run it once in your battle, in your hangar, I should say. You can't run two or three on the battlefield at the same time. So the key element of strategy becomes, when do you unleash the Titan? When do you put it into battle? Do you start off? Do you mass rush the battlefield, everybody in their Titans? Do you wait until an ebb in the battle and you can take advantage? Do you wait till the end and suddenly you can just stomp around and destroy everybody? It's going to be a really interesting dynamic to think about. Now, about the Pendragon Arthur itself, it's part of this new kick by Pixonic to introduce some lore into the game. So there's been this kind of cool thing on their official webpage, these secret documents, these dossiers on all these Titan robots that we've been learning about. Some of it's been redacted and blacked out just for fun to kind of up the mythology. We found out today that Arthur will have 345,000 health. It'll go 33 kilometers an hour, I assume, at level 8. And it has two shields. Each one has 127,500 health. And when you push your ability, the shields close, obviously, and protect you. But that comes at a cost. And what happens is that your speed is reduced by 20%. And that's called phalanx mode. There's also another little thing. It has an ability called Blast Wave. It works much like a Hellburner's Overload. It has a cooldown of 10 seconds, a radius of 80 meters. So if you're within 80 meters of the Arthur when it uses its Blast Wave, you will be hit by this shock wave, this Blast Wave, which will do 40,000 damage to anybody in that circle. And basically, as far as I understand, it works by just raising its foot up and stamping the ground, and just like the shock wave rips through your robots and actually causes them damage. Now, this obviously is not the only Titan that's going to be introduced. We have this new flying dragon, this dark dragon called Baikal. And I guess we're going to be learning in a future update what its special abilities are. It's really cool looking, actually. I really love the look of it. And then there's another one called the Outlaw, which again is just another one of these Titans. Now, they're all going to be equipped with various different weapons. And on the test server, we've got to see a few different types of weapons there. I don't even know what the names of them are, to be honest with you, but some of them are heavy machine guns. Some of them are almost like heavy long-range shotguns that shoot slugs. We also have what looks to be sort of a heavy Tolumbus rocket or something, like, but it looks different than, say, the Avalanche, which just hit the live server recently. Anyway, a lot of changes coming down the pike. There wasn't any official word when we're going to see this. Clearly, it'll be in another update in the weeks or months to come. And they're really encouraging everybody to get in on the test server and test it out. See if you like it. Give them some feedback, because this is going to be a huge change. For instance, they're so big, half these robots, these new Titans, can't actually fit under half the obstacles and barriers in the maps. They're going to have to redo the maps. They can't fit under the bridge. They can't fit under walkways. The center in Canyon, the Titans can't reach underneath there. So I guess they're going to be adjusting and changing maps to fit these new robots. you know, one of the things you're going to see some gameplay in this video a little bit later on, and one of the things you're going to notice is that these things seem to be really susceptible, or at least the Pendragon, Arthur does, to splash weapons. Because when you go shields up, it's no different than if you're in a Gareth or a Galahad or a Lancelot. You may have a hard shield that stops all the ballistics and all the energy weapons, but the bottom line is that if you hit with splash explosive, your health is going to go down. So a lot of times when I was playing and just testing and kind of just arsing around here, I was killed pretty easily with these splash weapons. People were hitting me and my shields really couldn't stop it. Now, maybe the other Titans will have different abilities that allow you to kind of get away from this type of easy counter to me, this easy counter to the Arthur, which is splash weapons, but that remains to be seen. You know, get on the test server, check it out yourself. I'd love to hear what you have to say about it. Leave me a message in the comments below. Tell me what you think. As always, if you like what you see, please click the subscribe and share button. And thanks a lot to everybody who has been subscribing. We're well over 100 subscribers now, and that's really exciting for me. And I really, I love doing these videos for you, and I hope you enjoy them too. So enjoy the footage. Maybe you can get on the test server and try it yourself. Until next time, stay away from the Knights of Nie, and I'll see you on the battlefield. We'll be right back.